Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And today's video is going to be my sheet mask that I used up during the month of August. And, I guess there's nothing else to really say on the introduction. Is I'm just going to show you what I used and talk a little bit about them. First one I want to talk about is this one right here from Skin Balance. It is the Donkey Milk gel mask for healing. And let me read to you what it says about the donkey milk that's in here. It has 0.5% donkey milk, and it's also referred to as white gold. Donkey milk has high content of omega-6, which boosts the skin's ability to prevent moisture loss. In addition, it contains vitamins and nutrients that help to purify and clarify the skin while boosting its radiance. So it does have a little bit of donkey milk in it, not a whole lot. So that's very interesting, because I really didn't think that it had donkey milk in it, to be honest with you. I figured it was just some kind of marketing ploy to get you to buy the cute little package with the donkey on there. I'm gonna see what else it says about this. Has nephrite powder, which is for purifying the skin. Camellia japonica flower water. I don't know what that is. I can't even read half of this. Has amino acids, basically, again, for purifying, clarifying. And then it has pear extract. So, anyway, I did enjoy it. I think this would be more geared towards someone that is probably acne prone. But as far as the mask itself, it was good. It was a good sheet mask. It was no slipping and sliding. There was enough essence in here to saturate the mask. It did not leave my skin sticky, so I did enjoy that one. The next one I have is from Alicia Coy, and it's the Caviar and Gold Firming and Nourishing Effects. And one of these, the top of it's torn off. This one, let's see what it says on the back of it. It says, oh no, I tore it all off, and the rest of it's in Korean, but it was okay. It was an okay mask. I think I have several of these, but it's, I'm not going to read this to you, because when they translate their packaging into English, it half the time it doesn't make any sense. But anyway, I did enjoy this one. It wasn't sticky, and it was a good one. The Naster is really good. This is the Pearl Mask. I do enjoy the Naster brand. And I know this brand you can find at TJ Maxx and at Marshall's, you know, places like that. Really good for hydration. It fit well. It was a thick mask. It was cotton, I do believe. The active ingredients was hydrolyzed pearl, hyaluronic acid, vitamin E, peony extract, herb extract, and a couple of things I can't pronounce. But anyway, as for moisturizing and to smooth sensitive skin, so I did use one of those. The next one I have is from Leaders. Leaders is another really good brand of mask if you are just getting into masking. And this is the Collagen Boosting Renewal Mask for firming and improving elasticity, and help with the appearance of fine lines. So, I get that to focus. So that was two of the Karuna masks. These are two that I just received from Octoly, and this was for brightening, it's for brighter skin. gently exfoliates the dead skin cells and reduces the appearance of age spots. I definitely did see some brightening, but as far as reducing the appearance of age spots, I feel like you would have to use these more than just a couple times. It would be something that would need to be in your skincare regime on a consistent basis in order to see the lightening effect. I don't know if you're going to be able to see that because there's some glare. Anyway, that was the Karuna brand. And then this one, this is from BioBell. And this was a 5-minute face primer mask that I used. I used this when I was out in Vegas. This was intended to put on before you put your makeup on. And how I did this was I did all of my skincare that I normally would do for that morning. And then I put this on for a good 5 minutes and then just kind of patted, you know, what was left of the essence in, and then I waited like a good 10-15 minutes before I put my makeup on. It was nice, but for me, I don't have that kind of time in the morning to mess with one of these, so, and I didn't really notice if it left my makeup on longer than normal, because I put my primer on like I normally would with that. But anyway, it does have some good ingredients. It has tea tree oil, rosehip extract, and vitamin C in it, which is good for the skin anyway. So it is, it's a good mask. I just don't think I would use it unless I just had a lot of extra time in the morning, like maybe on a weekend or something when I'm not feeling rushed. But, and I did get this at Ulta. I have another one of the Donkey Milks that I took. I think I took some of those with me when I was in Vegas. That's the reason why I had so many of those. This one I used in Vegas, and this was by the Cream Shop Perk Up Skin Animated Animal Face Mask infused with anti-aging collagen essence. And this one was kind of cute. It was cute to wear. I have a picture of it that I'll insert with it on, but I'm not a big fan of this brand, so I have some here and there still in my collection, but once those are gone, I won't purchase those. And I see them all the time at TJ Maxx and Marshall's, but for me personally, I would skip that brand. I just don't think it's that good. Another Korean mask. This is from Welkos, and it's made in Korea. This was the Jeju Natural Canola Honey Mask. This was for moisturization. It felt really good. I did enjoy this. This was a thinner mask. If I remember right, was it gel or cotton? I can't remember. But I did use that other Nastor in the tea tree. When we got back from Vegas, I felt like my skin was a little out of whack from, you know how it is when you go on vacation, your eating patterns off, your sleeping patterns off, different water, different atmosphere, weather. So anyway, I used one of those when I got back to kind of just help calm my skin down. I have two of these, and this is from the Tony Moly, and this was the Snail Mucin Skin Damage Care Master Lab, and did enjoy those. I'm pretty sure I got those from TJ Maxx also. Tony Moly line is another good mask line that you can buy. You can find them at Ulta, but you can find them at TJ Maxx and Marshall's cheaper, so be on the lookout for those. And then I have another one from Nastor. This is the Red Wine Mask Pack, and it removes harmful oxygen from skin, and I used this while I was out in Vegas too. I figured it would be a good one to help to detoxify and just replenish my skin from after being out in the elements all day. So I enjoyed that. Patchology Flash Mask 5-minute facial sheet illuminating that I used. It was nice. And then I have the from Peach and Lily, the Reset Button, which is soothe and restore for irritated, angry skin. And I like to use this one after I have taken my little razor and defuzzed my face, and my face is a little irritated from doing that, and I always like to use one of those afterwards. Helps to really smooth, soothe it and just calm it down. Have another one of the canola honey mask from that brand there. Juju, I guess. Juju Natural. Another mask that was from Peach and Lily. It's called Saturday Skin. This is a quenching mask. It's very highly moisturizing. It's a very thick cotton mask, and it just helps to really hydrate the skin. It has a whole lot of hyaluronic acid in it, with watermelon and aloe to help kind of soothe and hydrate the skin. And another one from Nastur. I think this is another pearl mask. I was really into the Nastur brand for some reason this past time. And then this one, I've talked about this one in a favorite. The Revive Extra Firming Mask. This was the collagen egg yolk. These are comparable to the Too Cool for School sheet mask. But I haven't been able to find them. I found them at Marshall's and at TJ Maxx, and I've been looking and looking to try and get more, and I haven't seen them in a while. So anyway, and then the last one I have is from Leaders. Leaders is another good brand for masking, and this is the wrinkle dressing, which is to help with wrinkles, dry skin, elasticity, and nutrition. So, and that is that one there. There we go. Maybe not such a glare. Anyway, so that is my sheet mask that I use for the month of August. So I hope that you enjoyed that. And make sure that if you haven't subscribed, to subscribe, especially if you like seeing reviews on sheet mask. Also, hit that little bell icon so that you're notified of any future videos so that you don't miss any. Anyway, thank you so much for joining me this evening. I hope that you have enjoyed, and I will talk to you soon.